Thank you very much for your presentation. May I now switch to Dr. Mukhopadhyay from India. The floor is yours.
Thank you very much, Chairman Sir. See, the nanomedicine in the Indian subcontinent is somewhat different from developed countries. In fact, the Indian system of medicine is based on the principle of nanomedicine. But this was practiced in the ancient times by Indians, but it never went into records on regulatory issues. It was depending upon the system of medicine and all these things. Of course, this is a, if you see the Indian mythology, you will see a lot of, you know, new nanomedicine drugs were used even for children to keep on the cheek when they are born. And in India, even now, ladies, they put their kajal, they say kajal, nanotubes on the eyes for decoration and other purposes. So before going to detail in India, then later we realized we don't have any regulatory issues, we don't have any system in our country and how to follow this thing. Then we started Bureau of Indian Standard and we became a member of ISO 229 nanotechnologies and all these things. Now the things are improving in India, especially in southern parts of India and Karnataka and all these things. I will show you some slides quickly how we have progressed in recent times, not only in biotechnology, but nanomedicine, nanotechnology. So, of course, this is a thing which we, everybody knows it. I am just skipping the things. Now, in India, of course, you can see how things are improving, and I will not read details, and you can grasp the, from the slide how things are moving. Then comes the nanotechnology once again in India, and what are the places, and what are the drugs which we have, these things, and what are the important, you know, devices or materials that are going in India. These are the three materials which perhaps you see in the slide. Then comes the nanomedicine. I was telling you nanomedicine, of course, we have a lot of formulation. If you see Indian system of medicine, Ayurveda, Unani, all these things, they dilute the drug. When they dilute the drug, the efficacy is more. The concept of nanomedicine was there, but there was no regulation, nothing. It is patient to patient. Similarly, we have these things in our country, and we have these things, many barriers that we faced because in our ancient system of medicine also doesn't have these things. And recently we started this thing, nanomedicine, in our country. We can see some of the slides which are representing this nanomedicine in our country. Some of the companies also, they came with products. These are the products. Some of the companies, Ranbaxy and other people, they started producing these nanomedicines in India. Of course, when we don't have regulatory issues, we approached FDA and we did these things. But the problem, see, you see, in India is a vast subcontinent, and every state has its own, you know, Ayurveda, this Siddha and Unani, all these type of medicines which are much more relevant to, similar to nanomedicine. So this nanomedicine, when you write regulatory issues, this Indian mythology plays. We have such mythology. If you see Ajanta paintings, we have nanomedicine. We have Tipu Sultan swords. They used to make this steel and export to Europe those days, and that steel has a nanomaterial. Still, if you see in Qutub Minar in Delhi, that it doesn't rust it. That means nanotechnology was lying those days also, these things. These are all internal, you know, these things. Only thing is how this mythology of Indian this medicine can be extrapolated to regulatory issues in this thing. And tell me, whatever we are talking regulatory issues here is engineered products. What are the natural products that we have in our body? Nanotechnology. Even the lotus leaf, they have nanotechnology. Even our ferritin, which we have in our body, is having nanotechnology. Our brain is a nanotech product. When we regulate these things, when we think we are thinking of only engineered products, what about the natural products that are occurring in our body, in the plants, in the insects, in the lizards? They have nanoparticles, and they crawl it, they use it, and they give a lot of technological inputs to the mankind. But we never incorporated, because when we write in ISO or any CEN or any regulatory bodies, or even FDA, we think only engineered products. This engineered products regulatory issue is different and depends upon the scaling up, depends upon the nanomaterials, depends upon so many products. So when we have these regulations, why we should not think of natural products? How people have entertained nanomedicines in ancient times? So this is what I want to stress to the audience, to the panel members also. When we write regulatory issues, we are writing only for engineered products. What about the natural products? Let us bring that product, that thing, how we are tolerating ferritin in our body. Why we cannot extrapolate that science, that knowledge in our regulatory issues? Nothing happened to us, ferritin is in our body. Nothing happens to the lizard, which has a nanoparticles. But here, when we engineered, we have a lot of things, a lot of uniformity missing, and a lot of regulations are to be incorporated because of depending of the country, company, industry, and stakeholders. So thank you very much.